What Paul is saying is that the whole world today is screaming, groaning, travailing. But it comes from the labor ward. In other words, this pain, though painful, is going to result in a fruit. It's going to result in something productive. It's going to result in something good, a child. And so, these groanings are not death pangs, but birth pangs. It does not result in hopelessness, but results in glorious hope. Every single upheaval of creation today is a representation of the labor pains of earth in its last final stage of pregnancy, or last final stage of labor. It's going to produce something wonderful. Changes the way you look at the world, isn't it? Well, you hear of volcanoes, you hear of eruptions, you hear of earthquakes. You know, that is not a sign that things are falling apart. Instead, it is a sign that things are finally coming together. And we are a day each time nearer to that beautiful day, blessed day, where all will be regenerated. That's what it means for creation to travail in pain. I've said a lot. It's, I think, quite an informative passage of Scripture. But let me apply this spiritually to our lives before we close. Number one, let us be reminded as we look at these verses about the dramatic, significant damage sin brings into lives. Just think about it. All it took was Adam to go against God once, to sin against God, and the whole creation is cursed. It speaks of the treachery and wickedness of sin. It speaks of the infinite holiness and righteousness of God. You see, we tend to play around with sin. It's okay to have a little sin here and there, but no, creation today reminds us. Every time you eat a durian, it should remind you. Every time you hear of a news of natural catastrophe, it should remind you about the grievousness of sin and the holiness of God. That's all it took. God is infinitely pure and holy, and I'm reminded of it as I study the Scripture in creation. Number two, as we look at this passage, let us be rejoicing and reminded about the amazing saving work of Jesus Christ. You know, in the Chronicles of Narnia, let me refer back to it as we close. Yes, Narnia's fate is inextricably and intimately related to the manifestation of the sons of Adam and the daughters of Eve. But they would never ascend to the throne without Aslan. Who is Aslan? Aslan is a lion. Without Aslan laying down his life for Edmund, one of them. Without that sacrifice, there will not be the ascension to the throne. And indeed, this world has no hope without Jesus Christ. This globe has no hope without Jesus Christ. You have no hope without Jesus Christ. But because of what he did on the cross, we will be saved. We will be glorified. And this world will be restored in glory. Wow. To me, it takes on a whole new meaning to look at those words in John 19:30. It is finished. It's a complete, total reversal of what sin has done, and more than that. I think the world that God is going to recreate is far better than the original one. My life with God is far better than that of Adam and Eve's, because no more am I just a created being, I'm his child. This is a world, or the future world, is one that will never, ever see corruption again. Can you imagine the saving work of Jesus Christ? If you today have not trusted in Jesus as your Savior, let me tell you, you have great danger, because you have no hope. This rotten, sick, and dying world is the only heaven you have. Because thereafter, the Bible says, you'll be cast into the lake of fire, which is reserved for the devil and his minions. But come to Jesus. He achieved it all. He paid the price for sin. He alone is able to save. But finally, I think the point that Paul is making in these verses is to encourage you. If you are a child of God today and you're going through sufferings, if you're in pain, please, please, you see, be reminded that your sufferings is only for a present time. Be patient. Hang in there. Don't give up on your faith. Stay firm, because there will come a day where all things will be made glorious. That's why Paul says in Romans 8:18, I reckon, I count, I calculate this, that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us, and if I may add, around us. So hang in there. You may have lost a child, lost your job. You may suffer terribly, but don't fall away from God. Don't believe in lies. Don't give up on your faith. Stay close. Hang in there, because God is working out for you a far more exceeding weight of glory. Creation is a message to God's people every single day of our lives. Hear what God has to say from His word and from His will. Let's bow for a word of prayer. Father, we are humbled once again, and we are grateful, because without your revelation in the Bible, we would not have an understanding where all this would head towards. We would have no clue what would become of this world and why this pain and futility and corruption has all come in. We are reminded today, dear Lord, that you are infinitely holy, pure, and righteous. Put in our hearts a holy fear and a holy reverence for you. Give us a hatred for sin as you hate sin. And as we have prayed earlier on, we pray that you will lead us now to Calvary and see the enormity of the sacrifice of your Son. That God, who hates sin, would take on the sins of the world and die for us. Lord, I cannot fathom. It does not. My mind cannot comprehend all that. But by your Spirit, would you allow your people, even today, to appreciate, to rejoice, to trust in the finished work of Jesus Christ. I pray for my friends who are gathered here and they're outside your kingdom. They do not know your Son. Lord, they are without hope. By your Spirit today, would you have mercy to give them that new birth, that they may appreciate your word and trust in you, that they would follow Jesus into everlasting life. Father, we pray too for those who are suffering. Lord, you are intimately aware of their pains. And yet in your sovereignty, in your infinite wisdom, you know this is for their good. It's for your glory. Would you strengthen their inner man, that they will not let up or give up, but they will keep trusting, keep walking, because you have reserved for us a day of tremendous glory. Give us that patience of Job. Give us that ability to persevere. Father, would you bless your word? I thank you again that we have a great hope of heaven. We have a great hope of a new world with you. Most of all, thank you that you will be with us henceforth forevermore. We praise your name. We ask this now in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless.